This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Vigilante 8 is a vehicular combat video game developed by Luxoflux and published by Activision. Originally released on the PlayStation in 1998, later ports of the game were released for the Nintendo 64 and Game Boy Color. It is a spin-off of the PC game Interstate 76, featuring several of its theme concepts: auto-vigilantes, the 1970s time frame, and specific fictional vehicle companies. Contents 1 Gameplay 11 Console versions 12 Game Boy Color version 2 Plot 21 Characters 22 Ending 3 Development 4 Reception 5 Legacy 6 References Gameplay Console versions. Players do combat over a number of stages located all over the Western United States, whether in story or arcade mode. Each stage has interactive features, such as ballistic missiles and launching Aurora planes for the Area 51 level. Every vehicle is equipped with a machine gun by default, but players can add up to 3 out of 5 available weapons: mines, auto cannons, rocket pods, mortars, and homing missiles, plus a special weapon unique to the vehicle. 3 types of special attacks can be made using each of the 5 standard weapons, at a bigger cost in ammunition, by performing fighting game-style movements and button presses on the control pad. These attacks may be performed during normal play or to eliminate nearly destroyed cars in a method called totaling. In line with the fighting game style element, players can also score up to 6 combo hits called whammies. There are special icons scattered across the playing field. Wrenches repair damage and yellow zigzag lines temporarily jam the opponent's homing-based weapons. Certain objectives in story mode must be completed to help unlock the game's secret characters and stages. The PlayStation version also offers players the option to play standard music CDs during a match. The Nintendo 64 version includes a story mode for Y the Alien and a fantasy stage called Super Dreamland 64, as well as 3 multiplayer modes: 2 vs 2, 3 vs 1, and Deathmatch. To take advantage of the system's 4 control ports, and a 2-player story mode, it also requires the Nintendo 64 expansion pack to improve the graphics and access bonus content. Game Boy Color version. The Game Boy Color GBC version features 5 levels, each one from the console versions: Casino City, Hoover Dam, Oil Fields, Ski Resort, and Valley Farms. The game also features 5 game modes, each one essentially identical, with only minor changes. The game's main story mode, Road Trip, takes the player through each level. The game features 3 difficulty levels. The player can choose from 5 different weapons, as well as a unique weapon assigned to each character. The game features digitized audio and voiceovers, as well as a 2-player mode made possible with the use of a game link cable. Unlike the console versions, obstacles and buildings cannot be blown up in the GBC version. The game cartridge features a rumble feature. Plot: the game is set in an alternate 1975, where a global oil crisis occurs and the United States is on the verge of an economic breakdown. A rampant crime wave in the cities prompts the deployment of more security forces, leaving the hinterlands with little or no law and order. A multinational oil consortium, the Oil Monopoly Alliance Regime Omar, is determined to control the global petroleum market and wants the destruction of the U.S. to ensure the success of their plan. Characters. The game's protagonists are the Vigilantes, a group of residents from various southwestern U.S. states who band together to preserve law and order in light of the chaos gripping the country. Their leader is Convoy, an old cowboy driving a semi-truck. He is accompanied in the fight by his niece Sheila, Las Vegas high roller John Torque, alien-obsessed hippie Dave, Torque's friend Slick Clyde whom he bullied to join the group, and FBI agent Chassie Blue, who was assigned to investigate reports of gun battles in the region. The game's antagonists are the Coyotes, a group of hitmen recruited to carry out Omar's scheme by terrorizing commercial installations throughout the region using weaponry stolen from the ultra-secret Site 4 base at Papoose Lake in Nevada. Their founder is known Australian terrorist Sid Byrne. His cohorts are disco dancer Boogie, a close associate, mentally disturbed S4 test pilot Loki, Beeswax, a beekeeper frustrated by the irradiation of his beehive, Houston 3, a woman brainwashed as one of Omar's assassins, and juvenile delinquent Molo, who is driving a school bus and is desperate to join the Coyotes. An extraterrestrial being named Y the Alien appears in the game as a secret character ending. Each character has his or her own ending, which is part of a bigger story. Molo successfully passes the coyote's initiation, only to be mocked as he is made to wash Sid's car. Sid receives his payoff money from Omar for his services, but is left stranded in the middle of nowhere because he is out of gas. John Torque finds him and stashes him in his trunk. Houston breaks free of Omar's mind control and goes away with Convoy, who detaches the machine guns from his truck. Sheila barely misses them at a gas station and is forced to walk on the road, where Convoy and Houston pick her up. Clyde wears Houston's mind control armband out of curiosity and emerges as the Coyote's new leader. Chassis Blue embarks on a Hollywood career, releasing her self-titled movie based on the adventures of the Vigilantes. An alien ship abducts Dave in the middle of the night, and he beats his alien host in a round of checkers. The police arrest Boogie and he is convicted on a number of charges. Beeswax is elated at having acquired two nuclear warheads, but dies when a stray bee lands on one warhead's fuse, triggering an explosion. Loki finds a UFO and is eager to fly it, but it crashes and he is mistaken for a live alien UFO pilot in the N64 version of the game. The ship Loki crashed is revealed to be that of Y, the alien, who was seeking extra fuel and parts for his ship after being stranded on Earth for some time looking for his friend's development. This section does not cite any sources. Please help improve this section by adding citations to reliable sources. Unsourced material may be challenged and removed. July 2016. Learn how and when to remove this template message. Vigilante 8 was developed with a team of only 5 people: Peter Moravec, Adrian Stevens, David Goodrich, Jeremy Engelman, and Edward Toth. A commercial for the N64 version was produced for its release in March 1999. It shows a school bus dropping off children at school, followed by game footage of the bus in combat. The students wait for their bus at dismissal time, only to find it severely damaged when it arrives. The advertisement was withdrawn following the Columbine Massacre. Reception review scores. Publication score: GBCN 64, PS GameSpot 71/79, 80/80, IGN 60/10, 82/10, 80/10. Vigilante 8 received positive reviews. Ryan McDonald of GameSpot graded the PlayStation version at 8 out of 10, noting the easy control scheme and the well-designed graphics. McDonald noted that the game's offerings would give reason for players to retire from Twisted Metal 2. Sean Smith of Electronic Gaming Monthly noted the N64 multiplayer mode offered more fun and ran relatively smoothly in high-resolution mode. Legacy. Further information: Vigilante 8 to 2 ND Offense and Vigilante 8 Arcade. A sequel was produced, titled Vigilante 8 to 2 ND Offense, released for the PlayStation, Dreamcast, and Nintendo 64 in 1999. A remake for the Xbox 360, titled Vigilante 8 Arcade, was created by Isopod Labs, an independent company formed by the founders of Luxoflux. The game features a high-definition rendition of the past games, plus some added multiplayer levels, complete with an online mode. It was released onto Xbox Live Arcade on November 5, 2008. The developer of the two Vigilante 8 games, Luxoflux, produced a game very similar to Vigilante 8 using the Star Wars license and the Vigilante 8 game engine, titled Star Wars: Demolition. References: ABCDE Harris, Craig. The 11th of January 2000. Vigilante 8 review. IGN retrieved the 20th of September 2010. Carrot Davis, Torrance. Vigilante 8 Arcade comes to Xbox Live Arcade.